Is Jake a pretty good pilot on the airplane there?
Yeah. Dennis Warner, yeah. I'm real nervous, I can tell you that. We had some fun with him. Now go ahead.
Coach, third year at SEC PDDs, how do your expectations now compare to year one?
Well, it's all about the same. It's my third straight year being last, so I'm looking to hit the cycle next year. Oof. I'd be last again, but now it's a kickoff to the season. Exciting time of year. We're all undefeated, so that's good for me. I haven't made any bad third down calls yet, but it's good. It's always good to get back to the ball.
Well, you're a couple of weeks away from preseason camp starting. Is everybody healthy, ready to go?
Yeah, I think going into camp, Levante Valentine will be cleared during camp at some point. He just got to strengthen his knee. Chad Terrell, I believe, will be cleared late September, maybe 1st of October. He's doing extremely well. Jabari Ellis had a scope yesterday on his knee. He should be cleared the first day. It's about a two-week window. Should be fine. I think all that's going to be good there. And JT Ebe, our graduate transfer from Rice, had labrum surgery on his hip in May. He will be cleared in camp at some point. I just don't know when yet. And other than that, we should be good to go.
Well, I know you've been confident since you were a toddler, but compared to 2 years ago when you came down here, and coming off a 9-win season, just how much more confidence do you have, especially with the familiarity of your team now?
Well, we've recruited well, and we've got a really good staff that develops players. And, I feel like we're in a much better place right now than we were 2 years ago, obviously. We've got really quality depth at the receiver, the running back, and the tight end position. I do think we've got some quality depth at some other positions. I really like those three, to be honest with you. So, but we're in a much better place right now than we were 2 years ago.
Coach Buddy Kirby Smart used a good phrase the other day, talking about Jordan, talking about how pressure is a privilege. And with you guys going into your third season, I know it's more about the outside of the pressure, but just looking at year three, I mean, how do you guys handle that kind of pressure, especially for the players who might not have handled some of the things?
Well, I think day-to-day. At the end of the day, goals and expectations are great, but if you don't understand what it takes to attain those goals, you don't understand the work and the everyday operation it's going to take to be successful, then you'll never achieve those things. And we're a day-to-day organization. Right now, we're trying to finish summer, and we need to have a great training camp. I go back to the great teams I've been a part of, the 2004 national champion in LSU, and the multiple conference championships I've been a part of. We all had great training camps, and our guys are focused on training camp and having a great training camp.
Will, you mentioned JT Ebe. What do he and Harvey bring to the secondary as kind of that immediate fill-in?
Well, both very bright guys. That's the first thing that strikes me. JT was a 3-year starter at Rice, a very physical player, a very smart player that I think is going to really help us. Nick is a guy that was an elite corner in our league 2 years ago and tore his ACL before last season. He looks really good moving around the short time that we've been with him. But the thing that strikes me with both of them is they're obviously mature guys, they've played, and we're lacking some experience about this.
What do you see Jamias being able to bring to that
safety? We're
going to
move Jamias to safety. And the guy that's got a great competitive edge, and I expect great things out of him.
What's the latest on Javon Charleston?
Florida, Clemson, Stress, those three games. We'll go a long way in determining the season. Against those three opponents next year, they get 2 touchdowns and 7 picks. Is there something when the stage gets big and the pressure gets high that you can do to help ease his anxiety or whatever it is in those situations?
No, I think at the end of the day, we need to play better, not just Jake Bentley, our entire football team. That's the way I would look at that situation. But, we look forward to those three games along with the other 9 we're going to play as well.
What's the latest on Javon Charleston?
What's that?
Charleston.
He's still suspended at this time, and I don't have any other comment to be honest with
you. Well, Georgia, in week 2, what did you learn about your team so early in the season? What are the benefits about, from playing a team that good in week 2?
We're looking forward to training for them. It's really good about it.
Can you talk about what Debo has had to go through this offseason to get back on the field? Just maybe some of the mental struggles.
It's exactly the mental struggles and the setbacks that you've got to deal with. But, God puts you through situations where you can handle the situation, be stronger from it, and to be able to handle this type of adversity, to be an athlete and have your feet taken away from you is tough. And that's a very difficult process to go through. I'm really proud of him, how he's handled the whole situation.
What do you expect from him?
What's that?
What do you expect from him?
Will, Steve Shaw told me 5 years ago there were 4 teams in this league as an RPO. Alex says all 4 teams have some kind of power.
Sure.
On film, how much has the use gone up in this league?
Well, I think it creates what I call run-pass confidence. So if they're asking a linebacker to play the A or B gap, and then he's got Q
carry on a receiver running down the field. You can't do that. It's impossible. So they create a lot of issues. In order to really defeat RPOs, you got to play man-to-man. If you don't match up well, you get in a situation where playing a bunch of man coverage to create issues for you as well defensively.
How much is it going up?
Oh, it's
30%, 40%.
I would say probably 60%.
Really?
It's everyone's got some form of it because all the defensive coaches understand how difficult it is to finish.
Is it fair to expect Deebo Samuel to start the way he started last year? Could there be a
Absolutely. That's what I'm expecting. Again, you look at 11 quarters last year, he's probably as electric, explosive player in college football. So that's certainly our expectation.
Who do you expect the place kicking competition to maybe go right up until the place kicking competition? You expect to go maybe right up until that first game?
Yes, I do. Stable at that position.
Does Jake Bentley fit into this group of quarterbacks in the SEC in your mind?
I think he's an elite player in our league. I think that he's played extremely well. He's matured beyond his years. He's got a great competitive edge. He's only the second player in school history as a sophomore to get 18 caps by his teammates. It shows you the respect he's gotten all organization. I expect Jake to have a great year. I think playing fast helps him. I think he processes extremely well.
You mentioned you're looking for improvements in camp. What specific improvements are you challenging your team?
Well, both lines of scrimmage. I feel really good about six offensive linemen that we've got probably about 80 starts with. But after that, I think we recruited well, but none of those guys have played on the offensive line, and we're not going to make it through the season with six. So we need to find out who's number 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Same on the defensive front. I feel really good about the first group that we're going to roll out there. And I think we've recruited well. The young players are talented, but they haven't played, so we've got to get them game ready by September 1st.
Well, where does Jake take his game from years two to three?
Well, I think being more efficient and taking care of the football better, and then being more technically sound as far as some of those teams has created some issues, but we got to take care of the ball better.
Coach, Debo's name will get thrown around, obviously, rightfully so, but for the rest of the guys, what do they bring to the table, the receiving corps? That makes it just a special unit.
One man's misfortune is another man's opportunity. Deebo went down and afforded Brian Edwards to be the feature guy, and he certainly accepted it and did extremely well. Shai Smith is a true freshman I thought played outstanding. Ortre Smith is a true freshman I thought played outstanding. Trying to get Rodriguez Davis healthy, which is getting back to that way, like he was a true freshman, he played extremely well for us. Chavis Dawkins, all those guys will get opportunities to touch the ball. Been impressed with Josh Vann in the short time that we've been working with him. Very Shai Smith-like guy as far as explosive change of direction. So I think we've got a good group of receivers.
What have you been to Boydre Smith just from the spring ball?
Well, I think, again, he's leaned his body down. He can really attack the ball on the top of routes. He's really strong-handed, heavy-handed on the top of routes to finish plays. So real excited about Boydre. It's a tough matchup.
You guys seem to be the chic pick to upend Georgia in the East and maybe turn that division upside down. You agree with the people who say that?
Well, again, I think we need to have a great training camp in order to have the type of season we want to have. Our goal every year does not change. It's to win the East and to win our state, and we haven't done that yet. We've made some progress, and we've got to continue to accomplish it.
Well, Bobby Bowden said that he underestimated the loss of assistant coaches like Rick Romano and Mickey. How does Nick keep the wheels on?
Well, I think he does a great job of evaluating coaches. Really good job of making coaches buy in philosophically to what he believes. He's obviously an outstanding defensive football coach, a special teams coach, and he recruits extremely hard. And then he does a really good job of philosophically getting his message across offensively. And so, there's one message in that program, and that's one thing that he's done an outstanding job of. He hired me, so he hired a good assistant.
Would you prefer to see a workhorse back, one guy separate a little bit, or do you think you're stronger?
I think that's really difficult in our league to have one back. The licks you take in our league are very difficult to have a feature back. I mean, certainly, you can have that guy great, but I think it's really hard to be able to make it through our year just thinking you're going to get one guy through the year.
Getting Joyner some snaps early on, something you'd like to see, or are you fine with him?
Anybody that can help us win football games, we're going to try and get him on the field. And certainly, Kerryon made a lot of progress during spring, and interesting to see how he does in training.
Do you feel more confident that you'll be able to get some push in the middle of the offensive line with Donnell?
We're getting Zach back inside is going to really help us. Sedaris Hutchinson is probably our best offensive lineman coming out of spring, and Donnell Stanley has been the leader of our offensive line group this summer. We've made a lot of strength gains on the offensive line. pleased with the work ethic of those six guys. Extremely pleased.
How big a deal is that interior push for that inside zone, just as your bread and butter, to be able to get three or
getting
four?
Getting a hat on a hat and get moving on the line of scrimmage to block the guys in our league is extremely difficult. I do think that the tempo is going to help us with that, Josh. The team makes cowards of us all, and sometimes a 300-pounder forgets to get his head in his gap each time.
Expectations for Shy this year?
For Shy?
Yes.
I think he'll have an outstanding year. I mean, he really played well as a true freshman. He's a guy that's really gotten his body stronger. And he looks much better than he did a year ago as far as from a weight room standpoint. Really bought in from the work ethic standpoint. He's got really good ball skills. He's got explosive change of direction in the slot. He's a difficult guy to cover in man-to-man. He can win versus press coverage.
Well, with the new redshirt rule, I mean, when do those talks start happening, especially for the freshman, when you're trying to figure out, okay, maybe we can get this guy some time and try to give him that experience?
I think it's a great rule. I wish we had it a long time ago. I think that it really enables you early in the season to play younger players that may or may not be ready, to put them in a situation to find out if they're ready. And then I think it really helps you at the end of the season when you have some injuries and you have some depth issues and you're holding a guy trying to redshirt, and now you're able to at least put him in the game and create some depth for your football team. So I think it's a great move.
Do those talks begin or have begun with some guys?
Oh, no, that would be the trainer.
So that's the trainer.
Yeah, I mean, we don't make any decision on a redshirt until the season starts. I mean, that's...
I just didn't know with the new rule, though, if you'd be thinking maybe just a little bit differently.
No, we got to see if they can help us. The bottom line, if they can help us win games, they're playing. And we've played more true freshmen than anybody in the country in the last 2 years. Print that.
What's the status of your signees getting into school?
Tyquan Johnson's the only signee that we're still working through, and I'm hoping to have that cleared up in the next couple of weeks.
Well, among your